Everyone knows that full-frame cameras are better than ones with crop sensors, right? Or are they? So what's a full-frame camera anyway? All that means is that the digital imaging sensor inside the camera body is the same size as an old frame of 35mm film. That was the most common film used by professionals for many years, so it's become the standard size for high-end digital cameras like the Canon 1DX Mark II and 5D Mark IV. But big sensors are expensive to make, so we also have camera bodies available with smaller ones. The 7D Mark II has an APS-C size sensor, which is smaller than full frame, and point-and-shoot cameras like the PowerShot G7X Mark II and phone cameras are even smaller than that. So what difference does this make in the real world? Well, generally speaking, image quality is better on full-frame bodies. Even if they have the same number of megapixels, the bigger sensors have those pixels, or photo sites, spread out over a larger surface area. Each one of those will be able to capture more light, and you'll have less noise in your images, can shoot at higher ISOs, and dynamic range is vastly improved. Also, the larger the sensor, the easier it is to get that nice out-of-focus background that makes your subject jump out of the image. So if that's the case, why would you consider a smaller sensor camera? Well, first, they're cheaper and usually lighter to carry around. And since the sensor is actually smaller, the camera is capturing a smaller portion of the image, essentially cropping your photo as you shoot it. This can be a good or a bad thing, depending on what you shoot. For example, if you put a 100 to 400 millimeter lens on an APS-C body, you have to multiply the numbers by 1.6 to get an idea of the perceived focal length. So it's 160 at the widest end and a whopping 640 millimeters when zoomed all the way in. If you shoot sports or wildlife, the extra reach is beneficial, but for landscapes, you have to buy wider lenses to get that super wide angle look after the crop is factored in. Look, at the end of the day, if you're making great images that move people in some way, it really doesn't matter how big your camera sensor is. But understanding the differences will help you pick the camera body type that works best for you. Hey, thanks for joining me and subscribing to the Adorama TV YouTube channel down below. Follow me on social media. I'm at David Bergman, and I will see you back here at the same time next week.